अलबर्टा दे प्रीमियर जेसन कैनी ने मंगलवार नूं एक कोविड अपडेट दौरान कहा है कि उन्हां दी सरकार ओमिक्रॉन वेरिएंट दे फैलन दी निगरानी करना जारी रख रही है, पर वाधू सेहत पाबंदियां एक आखरी ते सीमित उपाय ने। इस दौरान अलबर्टा दे चीफ मेडिकल अफसर डॉक्टर डीना हिंशा ने दस्या कि मौजूदा समय सूबे अंदर 34,000 कोविड दे नवे सरगर्म केस सामने आए ने।
First, I want to wish all Albertans a happy new year. 2022 may not be starting out as we had hoped for or envisioned, but despite our ongoing challenges with COVID, we do have good reasons to be thankful and optimistic about the year ahead, especially as Alberta continues to lead Canada in economic growth, and we see lots of good news on the jobs front and economic diversification. But just as we've wrapped up the holidays, I want to recognize Alberta's fantastic healthcare workers, the first responders and frontline workers who continue to give up time with their families to care for Albertans. We see the sacrifices that you are making, and everyone is truly grateful for your dedication, especially those of you who worked over the holidays and put in extra shifts. I also want to recognize the many Albertans who made the effort to limit their New Year's celebrations over the holidays, over the past weekend in particular. I know that none of this is none of us wanted to be ushering in a new year by having to postpone, cancel, or limit much anticipated gatherings with friends and family members. I know it's been disappointing, but the actions that we take now are critical to protect our healthcare system from the impact of this highly transmissible Omicron variant of COVID-19. While Omicron is less severe at an individual level, even a small percentage of a very large number of people requiring hospital care can put our healthcare system under real pressure. Today, we are reporting more than 30,000 active cases, and that's defined as people who have tested positive on a PCR test. But we know that the number is actually much higher with a positivity rate of 30%. And that's why we do expect to see hospitalizations rise in the weeks ahead. It's also why Alberta Health and AHS is doing everything they can to prepare our health system for the impact of this wave. I'm calling on the Government of Canada to help us out with that by taking immediate action to authorize the use of Pfizer's COVID antiviral pill, Paxlovid, that was recently approved for emergency use in both Europe and the United States and other jurisdictions. We need to use every tool at our disposal, and this can be a helpful tool for our physicians and frontline staff. This drug can be used for the treatment of mild to moderate COVID-19 in anyone that's 12 years of age and over who is at a high risk for progression to serious situations like hospitalization. The approval and subsequent procurement of this drug, it could help to save lives. Now, before Christmas, we announced additional public health measures to better protect our province, and this included reducing capacity by 50% for venues participating in the restriction exemption program that seat more than 1,000 people. It also included setting limits to those seated at a table, no mingling between tables, no interactive activities like dancing or billiards at hospitality businesses. And last week, we responded to the concerns of school boards and extended the holiday break for students from K to 12 until January the 10th.